A very good morning to one and all. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to Shri S.N. Ganju Memorial Inter-School English Debate 2021. Each year, we take great pride in hosting this event in the loving memory of our erstwhile Journal Secretary, Shri S.N. Ganju, a visionary, an impeccable leader, an educationist, and a founder member of Vishwa Bharati Women's Welfare Institution, a name that has become synonymous with quality in education and overall development of young minds as vigorous partners in march towards excellence. Shri S.N. Ganju was a great leader, and it is his dream that stands realized today in the repute the school has earned for itself, one that puts Vishwa Bharati Noida in the league of some of the most prestigious schools in Delhi NCR. Debates are the best means to gain new perspectives and hone public speaking skills all at the same time. It has always been our sincere endeavor to provide a platform to the budding orators amongst us to put across their thoughts, process them, align them, or even more, stand ground against those of others. This is also a platform for some vigorous brainstorming, as we believe that it's better to debate a question without settling it than to settle a question without debating it. The motion set before the House today is: the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. So without any further ado, let's begin by seeking the divine blessings of the Almighty for the auspicious commencement of today's event. Let's pay our reverence to Lord Ganesha, an epitome of good luck, good fortune, and great success. Coming up now, Ganesh Vandana, presented by the dance group of the school.
वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु
प्रथम नमन एकदंत
blessings of the Almighty in place, let's now move ahead with the proceedings of the day. It is said, a leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. Sometimes a short walk down the memory lane is all it takes to appreciate where you are today. Let's watch a video and reminisce about the beautiful journey of a great leader, Shri S. N. Ganju.
परोपकाराय फलन्ति वृक्षा परोपकाराय वहन्ति नद्यः परोपकाराय दुहन्ति गावः परोपकारार्थमिदं शरीरम् वृक्ष परोपकार के लिए फल देते हैं, नदियां परोपकार के लिए निरंतर बहती रहती हैं, गाय परोपकार के लिए दूध देती है और यह मानव शरीर परोपकार के लिए ही है।
Leaders become great not because of their power, but because of their ability to empower others. Vishwa Bharati Public School, Noida, remembers Shri S. N. Ganju, our leader, as a source of inspiration, a groundbreaking visionary with a heart so full of life that it transcends age and time. Shri S. N. Ganju was a skilled orator who retained his zeal for hard work right till the end. After 35 years of selfless service, he left for his heavenly abode on this very day, 29 October 2003. Leaving behind a lasting legacy of excellence. Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is a success. Since the inception of this beautiful temple of knowledge, our revered Shri S. N. Ganju and other honorable members of school management have worked tirelessly to provide a platform for holistic development. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Amidst the aroma of pine trees, the vibrancy of saffron, the warmth of kahwa tea, and the sound of gushing water, the Vishwa Bharati Education Society was founded in Kashmir 70 years ago. This academy has been a social and educational movement, a commitment with the sole aim of spreading education among the masses and to women in particular. A river cuts through a rock not because of its power, but because of its perseverance. The Vishwa Bharati Institute persistently strives to fulfill Shri S. N. Ganju's dream of making the establishment a force to be reckoned with. Today, with God's grace, our humble venture has grown into an educational empire comprising schools and colleges in the townships of Srinagar, Jammu, Noida, Greater Noida, Ghaziabad and Dwarka. Shri S. N. Ganju believed that education is not only essential to an individual but is a fundamental requirement of a developing nation. Vishwa Bharati Noida has already carved a niche for itself in the NCR and at the national as well as international level. We remain eternally grateful to Shri S. N. Ganju, whose impeccable leadership and undying wisdom guides us to this day. The Vishwa Bharati management decided to commemorate our erstwhile General Secretary, Shri S. N. Ganju, by paying a tribute to his passion for debating and public speaking. Instituted in 2003, Shri S. N. Ganju Memorial Inter-School English Debate is held each year as a mark of respect to the 35 years of dedicated service rendered by him. Students are encouraged to debate about numerous issues pertinent to the current scenario. The huge repertoire of ideas, thoughts and views celebrates his legacy. It is rightly said, legacy is not leaving something for people. Legacy is leaving something in people.
Indeed, we at Vishwabharti shall always remain eternally grateful and forever indebted to Shri S. N. Ganju for his selfless service and undying wisdom. On this note, may I now request our constant source of motivation and inspiration, our principal, Mrs. Veera Pandey, to accord a formal welcome. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Rupinder. Good morning and namaskar to all present. A very warm welcome to our esteemed management members, principals of our sister concerns, and other invited guests who have joined us this morning on this virtual platform. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to our most prestigious event, Shri S. N. Ganju Memorial Inter-School English Debate Competition. As you are already aware, this event is held every year in memory of our most respected and erstwhile General Secretary, Shri S. N. Ganju, who till this day remains a source of great inspiration for all of us. He was a great academician and an educationist whose dream of making Vishwabharati reach the pinnacle of success stands fulfilled. I would also like to welcome our panel of learned judges, Ms. Shubha Srivastava and Ms. Vartika Mishra. I wish you all the best in judging today's event. We also extend our hearty welcome to the participating teams and their teacher in charges. And I would request the teacher in charges to communicate and to communicate my personal regards to the principals for sending the teams to the school for participation. It has always been our constant endeavor at Vishwabharati to provide a suitable platform to the young learners where they can share their deep insights on various burning issues of society. And today's debate event will surely give us all an opportunity to listen and ponder over the motion set for the house. The pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. I wish all the participating team the very best of luck for today's debate. Thank you. Over to you, Rupinder, to continue.
Thank you so much, ma'am. We at Vishwabharati are blessed to have patrons who are a constant support system in all our endeavors. We are honored to have Dr. Professor R.K. Shivpuri as the Vice President of Vishwabharati Women's Welfare Institution. A profound scholar and an educationist par excellence, he has had an illustrious career graph of more than 43 years in numerous capacities behind him, which includes holding the prestigious position as the Professor and Director, International Relations. Dr. Professor Shivpuri is ever so encouraging when it comes to development of young minds. It is our great honor to share his message on this occasion.
Good morning to one and all. On behalf of the school management, it gives me immense pleasure to extend my best wishes to each one of you who have joined us for our annual debating event, Shri S. N. Ganju Memorial Inter-School English Debate Competition. At Vishwabharati, we firmly believe that education is not only essential to an individual but a fundamental requirement of a developing nation. Our hallmark has been excellence in whatever we do, and debating is a very integral part of the school's learning teaching process. Right from planning your argument, even if it is the one you disagree with, to choosing your words with care, debating can prepare anyone to take on any challenge in life may present to you. It goes without saying that the importance of encouraging students to develop critical thinking skills as well as articulating their thoughts in a confident manner is imperative for overall personality development of any individual. Finally, I would like to appreciate the school for selecting a very appropriate and relevant topic for today's debate. The pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. I wish all young orators the very best of luck for today's debate. We appreciate your efforts to show keen interest in participating in this debate competition. And for us, you all are already winners in your own right. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your best wishes. We are also delighted to have amongst us yet another senior member of school management, Professor A.N. Sadhu. Sir is a great academician and has had an enviable career graph, which includes holding the position as the Vice Chancellor of University of Jammu. A multifaceted personality and a peace activist, Professor Sadhu has authored various research papers and has been a part of numerous national and international seminars. We would now like to share his message on this occasion.
Well, I'm very happy to learn that Vishwabharati Public School has chosen a very important theme for discussion among the young students. So far as the perfectionism is concerned, I personally feel that it is an idealism and not an achievable target. But students should always look for excellence and optimum performance. Putting the young boys and girls in the race for perfectionism may prove detrimental to their mental health, because perfectionism is not achievable, while as optimum performance is very highly achievable, and that puts the students on comparative advantage of having done better now than what they did earlier. So I would personally feel that to avoid pressure on the mental health of our youngsters, they should look for excellence and they should look for optimum performances, because optimum is always achievable, while as the perfectionism is elusive, and anything that is elusive can cause stress on our youngsters, young boys and girls who have otherwise been shining in all fields of our science, technology and other managerial disciplines. We should avoid putting them under stress, because stress results into underperformance, while as our young boys and girls should be motivated to go for the optimum performances, which is the best performance they can put in as per their level of merit, understanding and delivery. I'm sure that if our students go for optimum performances, it will result into better mental health, better motivation and better pursuit of doing things on a higher level than what they have done in the past. And that is how we should motivate these young boys and girls to move forward and achieve levels which are higher than what they have achieved earlier, but do not go for perfectionism, which may prove elusive and counterproductive in the long run.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable words and your perspective on the topic. I'm sure all the debaters must have got a lot of ideas, you know, from the sir's perspective, from what he has shared with all of us. On that note, I now invite the chairperson for today's debate, Shreya Shukla, to take charge of the proceedings. Over to Shreya.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Perfection in today's world is seen as the equivalent of hard work, the sole path to success. While perfection itself is not attainable, it can fuel our motivation to work relentlessly towards our goals. But at its roots, is perfectionism the same as being meticulous? Or is it fear? A fear of making mistakes, a fear of disappointing others, maybe even a fear of not being good enough? Is perfectionism the reason behind rising cases of mental health? Or is it a recipe for sound mental health? To explore this question, the motion on the floor is the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. We are honored to have with us Ms. Vartika Mishra and Ms. Shubha Srivastava as the judges panel for today's event. Our first judge for the debate is Ms. Vartika Mishra, an educator with 20 years of experience to her credit. She is the co-founder and program manager at Aim to Excel, an AI-based program for effective career planning for the students of classes 6 to 12. During her 15 years of teaching at schools for the elite, as well as the underprivileged, she has helped students realize their potential, create an impact on society, and lead a life of fulfillment. As the head counselor at Aim to Excel, she guides students to discover their strengths, interests, and personality. Thank you very much, ma'am, for accepting our invitation. We are honored to have you here. May I please request you to share a few words?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Am I audible?
Yes, audible? Ma'am.
Good morning all. I'm Vartika Mishra from Aim to Excel, and it's an honor and pleasure to be invited as the judge here. The topic for today's debate is actually very apt and relevant to the modern day living. And when I received this topic, I was intrigued by this word perfectionism. What do you mean by perfectionism? You know, it has different meaning for different people. You know, how you see life, what are your standards of perfectionism? It is different because every person has different perceptions, beliefs, and experiences in life. And every person strives to achieve different goals. So we all have different definitions of perfectionism. And for the past more than 20 years, I have been working with students of adolescent age from 6 to 12, 9 to 12, basically. And I have encountered a lot of students who strive to be perfectionist. And I have seen the positives and the negative sides of being a perfectionist. The positive could be it's a great motivator, encourager, and you can aspire larger goals, your dreams and visions can become fulfilled by being a perfectionist, because you're aiming, you're focused. And the negative side is it leads to a lot of stress and anxiety, of course. And one thing which I noticed was that perfectionists have a fear of failure. They are not able to take failure very well. And the failure, by failure, I mean their own definition of failure, not what the world sees as failure, but what they feel failure is. I'll give you a small example. Claude Monet, you must have known, he was a famous French painter, and he was the founder of Impressionist painting in the world. He once said, "My life has been nothing but a failure." I mean, a person of that stature said that. And he would burn paintings, before the exhibition. So failure is different for different people. Perfectionism is different for different people. How it affects people, students, what their own life goals are, it depends on that. It is your own mindset. What you want, what you aspire to become in life. Do you want to be successful in the life, in the eyes of others, or do you want happiness and fulfillment for yourself? So that is what we have to decide. That is what the students of today have to decide. What is your mindset? So I won't take much time of everyone, and I wish all the contestants all the best. And I'm really looking forward to this engaging contest. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your informed words, ma'am. We welcome you. Our next judge, Ms. Shubha Srivastava, is an independent corporate ethics investigator and trainer with more than 20 years of hands-on experience in evaluating ethical issues and gender sensitivity within institutions. She holds a master's in English literature and an MBA in Human Resource Management. She is a certified trainer from the Indian Society of Training and Development and has significant experience in people management, including internal communications. An active debater herself throughout school and college days, Ms. Shubha is always eager to be a part of debate events. Ma'am, we are extremely humbled by your presence. May I please request you to enlighten the gathering with your kind words?
Shreya, thank you so much. Thank you, everybody, the management of Vishwabharati Public School for having me here in this event. Like Shreya said, yes, debating is very close to my heart personally from our student days. But more than that, I think what has really enthused this debate competition today is the theme. And like Vartika mentioned, or like, you know, our other esteemed panelists have already mentioned, how the theme of, you know, talking about pressure of perfectionism is so valid and relevant in today's date. I couldn't have really thought of a better topic. This is also something, friends, that is very close to me personally, because I have seen mental health issues from very close quarters in my extended family. So this theme is not just a theme for today. This is actually something that I and my family, we live through every day. So without really saying much about the topic, I'm rather keen to hear all the, you know, panelists, the debating teams talk about the pros and the cons of it. And the interesting thing is that even those who are against the motion that, you know, it can be a pressure, there is enough and more to hear on both sides of the story. So really wishing all these speakers all the very best. And I'm sure, you know, at the end of this competition, I as a panelist and somebody who's hearing all the points of view, I'm going to go back richer with all the views and insights. So thank you so much and wishing everybody all the very best.
Thank you very much, ma'am. We welcome you. Words have magical power. They can bring either the greatest happiness or the deepest despair. Words enable the orator to sway his audience and dictate its decisions. Words are capable of rousing the strongest emotions and prompting all men's actions. With these words in mind, I now declare the debate open. Let's get acquainted with some important rules before we begin with the event. This competition is open for classes 9th to 12th. Each team will have two speakers, one for the motion and one against the motion. Each speaker will be given 3 minutes to speak. A short warning bell will be sounded at 2.5 minutes. The second and final bell will be sounded at 3 minutes. Marks will be deducted on exceeding the time limit. Participants will be judged in the following categories: content, relevance and originality, voice modulation and delivery, and overall presentation. The name of the school should not be mentioned at any time during the competition. Reading from a script is not permitted. Participants are required to turn on their cameras while they are speaking. Participants must keep themselves on mute when another speaker is speaking. All the participants should be in their school uniform. Participants must put up the virtual backgrounds provided to them. The sequence for the event will be as intimated before, so everyone is requested to be ready according to their team code. First up, we have team BB01. I request the speaker for the motion, Ankita Verma, to please turn on her video.
A very good morning to one and all. Today, I, Ankita Verma of team 1, will be speaking for the motion, "The pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health." I need to ace this test for a perfect future. I need to put this lotion on my face to look perfect. All of my practice would be for nothing if I don't play this match perfectly. My life is such a waste if I don't score perfectly in boards or find the perfect job or find the perfect match. We all have heard these voices in our heads, haven't we? Because from a very tender age, we are taught to succeed. And soon, this desire to excel turns into the desire to be perfect. We find ourselves aiming for some superficially high standards and hunting for some rapidly diminishing satisfaction. And this obsession of ours doesn't accept the rules of time. Because once a standard is set, it is carved on stone. Even if it goes from aiming high to virtually impossible, there is no stopping. And no wonder it causes mental strain, anxiety, guilt, OCD, and even depression. You still ask why being a perfectionist is awful. Well, seeking absolute perfection is nothing but hunting for a blanket to hide your fears of failure and hunger for acceptance. And it gives you nothing but a sense of worthlessness. From sending back his food 3 times in a restaurant to ensuring just the positioning of a piano at an event, Steve Jobs has had manic episodes of perfection. I think we need to understand that there is a huge difference between striving for excellence and rooting for absolute perfection. Because when athletes like Simone Biles are admitting the pressure to win and dropping out of the Olympics, when students like us are sacrificing their lives because they couldn't crack a certain exam, it is enough evidence to call off this race for perfection. We don't need it. For me, achieving our goals should never come at the cost of our sanity. Your quirks and even your little mistakes, they infuse your work with personality and color. So leave perfect precision for machines. And remember that to err is human. And to be human is perfection. Thank you.
Indeed, an interesting argument. I now invite Simran Sharma from team VB01, who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, team VB02, is requested to be prepared for their turn.
Good morning. Today I, Simran Sharma of team VB1, will be speaking against the motion, pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. I am a perfectionist, and I speak it with clarity and all humility. I am detail-oriented and incredibly dedicated to making sure that my work is flawless. The naysayers around me say that perfectionism is unattainable, and surprisingly, I agree to it. Yes, we can never attain perfection, and it's okay because it's a part of what makes us human. But that does not mean that we stop striving for it. I believe that a person who knows that perfectionism can never be attained will never be under the so-called pressure of always turning out perfect work. Instead, he'll always try to give his best, and the result will not only fill him with a sense of accomplishment, but will serve to strengthen the good things in him. I believe that chasing perfection is what leads us to excellence. Chasing perfection is what constantly motivates us to pour our all in whatever we undertake. And perfectionism is even more fantastic when you are on the receiving end of things. Shahjahan, for instance, was elated at the sight of Taj Mahal. The intricate design, the splendid architecture, and tireless years of hard work still mark the excellence of Mughal architecture, and that is what we know as perfect. It is widely believed that perfectionists tend to react negatively to criticism, because they equate criticism with failure and failure with worthlessness. But I believe that there needs to be a balance because excess disrupts harmony. Those who give their best and treat failures as learning opportunities rather than indicators of inferiority are, for me, the good kinds of perfectionists, achievers with high standards of excellence. And honestly, this is the definition of perfection which I carry in my heart. I really do not get what is wrong with aiming high. Shooting for perfection must make one feel inspired, not anxious. Okay, I let you decide. Decide what you would want to be. A loser, hiding under the blanket of procrastination, or the winner, setting standards of excellence and perfection and tasting the jubilation of success. The choice is yours. Thank you, and I would like to rest my case.
Thank you, Simran.
Well spoken, team VB01. Next up is team VB02. I invite Eshani Sood, who will be speaking for the motion.
Before I started writing the speech, I stared at my computer screen for a while, thinking about how I'm going to put my thoughts into writing. And I felt overwhelmed by the countless ideas in my head and the millions of words I could turn them into. Yet I did not know which way would suit this topic best. And while saying it, I still think, is this the best I could have done? Good morning, judges and my fellow participants. Today, I, Eshani Sood, am speaking for the motion, "The pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health." First of all, what is perfectionism? It's a combination of excessively high personal standards and overly critical self-evaluations. Even inconsequential things frustrate us, as the negative aspects always take precedence. In the days of social media, there is immense pressure to have a perfect life, and apps such as Instagram are widely associated with high levels of anxiety, depression, bullying, suicidal ideation, and even cardiovascular disease, all side effects of socially prescribed perfectionism. By now, I think you get the gist of things. The desire to be flawless is not only exhausting and draining, but living with the thought that even your best efforts aren't providing your idealistic results makes things worse. Nobody can motivate you to do better more than yourself, but it is also true that nobody can make you feel lesser than others more than you can. My opponents may argue that taking away the desire to be perfect is basically rejecting hard work. But let me make myself clear. There is a difference between the healthy and unhealthy version of perfectionism. And sometimes we cannot differentiate between which one we might be burning out over. Harvard combed through 4 decades of data of nearly 25,000 working age individuals to see if perfectionists were better performers at work. They found that perfectionism is a much bigger weakness than assumed. Students too are very vulnerable, since this time in their life will greatly impact many aspects of their future. Instead of telling people to be perfect, society might be better off just going for good enough. Trying to be the model human being breaks people bit by bit. And while it does take some practice, eventually everybody needs to learn that we can do things, not be perfect, and yet still feel valued. It can be liberating, allowing imperfection to happen and accepting it and celebrating it. To conquer your flaws, you must first accept them and wear them with pride. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ishan.
That was good.
Indeed, a compelling perspective. I now invite Pratiksha Singh from team VB02 to speak against the motion. I request the speakers from team VB03 to please be ready.
One day, a mathematics teacher wrote the table of 7 on the board. She intentionally wrote 6 times 7 as 43. All the students started to laugh. The teacher replied, "I wrote 10 statements on the board, out of which 9 were correct and only 1 was incorrect. But instead of appreciating me for writing 9 correct statements, everybody criticized me for writing a single incorrect statement." Good morning, everyone. Today, I, Pratiksha Singh, am going to speak against the motion, "The pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health." In this pandemic, the pressure on doctors, scientists, and other frontline workers to save lives as soon as possible led to the creation of a successful vaccine, proving that pressure is the mother of performance. The painting of Mona Lisa, which took 7 years to be completed, our Indian monuments such as Ajanta Ellora Caves and the Konark Sun Temple with magnificent stone carving display the quest of perfection that our ancestors had, proving that if we want success, we cannot afford to leave the hand of perfection. In Manusmriti, it has been told that if there is no fruit, people will not be motivated to perform their duty. Similarly, I argue that if there is no pressure to be perfect, people will not be motivated to put complete efforts in a task. My worthy opponents will say that perfectionism makes people live with the thought that even their best efforts are not providing idealistic results. In response to that, I argue that the pressure of adaptive perfectionism forces you to think that are the efforts which you are putting really your best efforts? Another argument may point to the fact that perfectionism encourages self-criticism, which does more harm than good. In response to that, I want my audience to put themselves in place of a candidate who has not self-criticized herself. Don't you agree that she would feel more demotivated if she is not able to answer a question regarding her weakness because she has not self-criticized herself? No matter which religion you follow or which language you speak, the quest of perfection is human nature because it is the very fundamental of nature. Humans evolved from a single cell, and it is due to the burning desire of perfection in humans that today we can proudly say that there is much more evolution in us compared to the apes than just a tail. I believe if we do not chase perfection, it will be against the fundamental of nature. Pleasure in the job puts perfection in the work. Therefore, we must strive for perfection with joy and forget all reasons why it won't work and believe the one reason why it will. Thank you.
Thank you, Pratiksha.
Wonderfully spoken, Team VB02. Next, I invite Ansh Koyal from Team VB03, who will be speaking for the motion.
Am I visible and audible?
Yes, audible.
Yes, Ansh, you are.
Thank you. The interviewer questioned me, Mr. Ansh, what would you say is your most blatant weakness? After considerable thought, I said, ma'am, I think my most blatant weakness is perfectionism. You know, the raven of constantly striving for better. She was left both baffled and amused and said, Mr. Ansh, now I have a string of questions for you. Firstly, where is the destination where you wish to reach? Secondly, is it leading to your holistic development or is it leaving you more hollow than ever? And finally, is it really worth it? I've been addressing perfectionism ever since. Whining with thirst, I follow myself to you. The wind turns savory, watery, moist, and drenched. The bluster too wants me to admire you, but you are too governous an entity to be consumed. A very pleasant morning, respected jury members, teachers, and my worthy audience. I'm Ansh Koyal, present before you to say with strength and conviction, yes, I do feel that the pressure of perfectionism is highly detrimental for our mental health. Dear perfectionist, I mind you, you are not going to be Nostradamus trapped in a prison full of heretics seeing the unforeseen. You are going to be the Rapunzel that waits for her Prince Charming her entire life, knowing that she doesn't have long enough hair. But your heart will always yearn for the picture perfect. This brings us at a very important point in today's discussion, one around which I shall be dwelling my argument. Perfectionism is a gambit. Perfectionism is an illusion. Perfectionism is that particular mirage that will give you the promise of a water that is sweeter, bluer, and probably comes with a box full of candies. But it will always keep you oblivious to the fact that yesterday evening you've had pizza, you are already high on calories, and you need to take a break. In the past years, many famous celebrities, including the likes of Naomi Osaka, Simona Biles, Virat Kohli, and Ben Stokes have come forward to voice the asphyxiation that they felt because of the constant pressure of delivering results. The rise in perfectionism is specifically distressing because of its association with mental health diseases. According to a meta-analysis of 284 studies, rise in perfectionism gives rise to anxiety, depression, eating disorders, OCD, and even self-destructiveness. My fellow opposition might question me that if human beings do not strive for better, how will they find meaning in survival? I respect the argument, however, honorable jury members, there's a massive difference between striving for better and perfectionism. What makes perfectionism toxic is that human beings try to achieve standards that virtually do not exist, basically preparing a recipe of disaster for themselves. In the words of Paul Hewitt, dealing with perfectionism is like dealing with a child who's afraid of a humongous imaginary monster under his bed. Finally, I would like to conclude by saying, I do not regret not being perfectly under the flash all the time. Well, that's something magically subjective in nature. I feel blessed, bestowed upon, till the time taking that giant leap off the cliff defines my nomenclature. Thank you.
Thank you.
Quite an eloquent argument. I invite Khushi Kalyan from team VB03, who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, team VB04, is requested to be prepared.
Vince Lombardi, famous American football coach, once said that perfection is not attainable, but if we chase perfection, we can catch excellence. Perfection has been ingrained in our culture. Workplace environments, educational standards, competitions, all reward flawless performances. School toppers, Olympic gold medalists, and CEOs worth billions enthrall and inspire us. In fact, my dear orators, isn't that what we're trying to achieve here today? Perfection? Because deep down inside, we all know that nothing would make us more happier or satisfied as debaters than winning this competition. A very pleasant morning to one and all. My name is Khushi Kalyan, and I truly believe in chasing perfectionism, as I know it will make me a better learner and a much motivated person. Perfection is a moving target, and that is why it keeps providing us with new challenges to achieve higher goals. My stunning opponents would have already provided you with a lot of statistics based on mental health issues, but didn't we have similar patterns of competitions existing in ancient times as well? We never heard of any such issues existing in that time. Well, this is because nowadays, it's just very easy to... Wait a second, please. I'm really sorry. These days, it's just very easy to blame the humdrum problems of your life on mental health illnesses, because a lot of awareness is being spread on this topic. I would say that this is a classic example of the escapist tendencies of humankind. Yes, there are many famous personalities who have come forth and talked about their personal experiences of dealing with mental afflictions such as depression. For example, Virat Kohli, Deepika Padukone, and even APJ Abdul Kalam. But did they stop there? No. They kept striving for perfection. And by doing that, they have proven time and again to the whole world that they are the very best in their respective fields. When approached in a positive manner, perfectionism teaches you how to bounce back quickly and how to stay engaged even during a myriad of performance setbacks. In a recent interview, India's pride gold medalist Neeraj Chopra mentioned how he himself bounced back from the pit of depression because of his determination to be the very best version of himself. This is a classic explanation of how perfectionism is an incentive to do better rather than the cause of various mental health issues. I would like to conclude by saying that there is nothing wrong at all with wanting to be perfect, but the pressure of being perfect should be our own pressure of bettering ourselves, of improving. Furthermore, it is the attitude towards perfectionism which needs to be corrected here. Instead of being perceived as success-based, it should be taken as learning-based. With that, I rest my case. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Khushi.
Great work, team VB03. Now we have team VB04. I request the speaker for the motion, Mufaddal Alavi, to please turn on his video.
I hope I'm audible as well as visible.
Yes, you are.
Okay, I will start. Perfectionism hardly begets perfection or satisfaction, only disappointment. In fact, there's nothing perfect, and perfectionism is a mirage. Heartiest greetings to one and all present here. Today, I, Mufaddal Alavi, with team code VB04, will present my deliberation for the motion. That is, the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. Yes, I strongly believe that perfection is basically a myth which all of us run after, not realizing that you're bound to be disappointed. Let me ask you all, what is this so-called perfectionism that we're continuously trying to inculcate? I would define it as a self-deprecating way to achieve something which practically does not exist in the first place. Isn't it ridiculous? It has also been observed that those who are perfectionists tend to put extraordinary efforts in doing even a simple, mundane task, so much so that even a minute flaw or imperfection irks them to death. And this eventually leads to deterioration of mental health. Yes, you heard it right. The obsession for perfection among the youth is ever increasing, which unfortunately does not indicate that they are becoming more accomplished and successful, but on the contrary, is leading the new generation towards depression and diffidence. You will agree that perfectionism has become the root cause of diseases like obsessive compulsive disorders, social anxiety, and several other psychological disorders, which is really alarming. Breen Brown, a research professor at the University of Houston, has rightly remarked that perfectionism is not the same thing as striving to be your best. So, aim for success and not perfection, because beneath every perfectionist's mind, there is a poor soul dying from anguish and tired of fighting against the atrocious desire for making everything flawless. I conclude my argument with the insightful words of Stephen Hawking. One of the basic rules of the universe is that nothing is perfect. Perfection simply doesn't exist. Without imperfection, neither you nor I would exist. So, my dear friends, let's stop chasing perfection and celebrate life with all its imperfections. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Badal.
Indeed, an interesting argument. I now invite Abhiraj Sen Gupta from team VB04, who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, team VB05, are requested to...
Am I visible and audible?
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Okay.
Should I start?
Abhiraj.
Thank you.
Yes, please.
Success is the result of perfection, hard work, learning from failure, and persistence. The aforesaid quote by Colin Powell holds absolutely true today when we, willingly or unwillingly, join the incessant race towards the goal of attaining sublime success. We must chase perfection, just sheer perfection, to catch excellence and be a winner. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Abhiraj Sen Gupta, with team code VB04, I'm going to speak against the motion, that is, the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. Frankly speaking, I completely disagree with what my worthy opponent has just said. And they feel that perfectionism is harmful for our health and is just a mere illusion. Why? I ask them. Now, what is perfection? I trust it is the pursuit of an individual to keep going higher and higher till he reaches the pinnacle of excellence and zenith of glory. And let me remind you all that this yearning for perfection is the mantra of success in contemporary times that we all live in. In fact, since time immemorial, it has been believed that the art of perfecting oneself is the fundamental base of all progress and moral development. Perfection gives humans power and potentiality, recognition and acceptance, the essential ingredients needed for impeccable success. Just success. Next, I would like to call your attention to the fact that the pressure involved in attaining perfection is just self-imposed. And you all will agree that it is we who take the coercion too seriously and eventually disrupt our poor health. Why, I ask? We need to remember to stay composed, and the pursuit of perfection should be realistic and balanced. That's the mantra, I believe. Theodore Roosevelt, the 26th president of the United States, had rightly said once, keep your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. That's perfection. We all know how passionate an artist is about his artwork and accomplishes his task with full dedication and mere precision to give the world a masterpiece to cherish, a work of sheer perfection. And dear friends, this perfection is not only restricted to work, but our relationship with people must also be perfect and not just casual. Hereby, I rest my deliberation with a very, very famous saying by the Greek philosopher and physicist Aristotle. Perfection consists not in doing extraordinary things, but in doing ordinary things extraordinarily well. That should be the mantra of your life, the mantra of your success. Thank you and have a nice day all.
Thank you.
Thank you, Abhiraj.
Well spoken. I would request everyone to please adhere to the time limit. Next up is team VB05. I invite Mehak Magotra, who will be speaking for the motion.
Good morning to you all. I am Mehak Magotra from stream VB05, and I am going to speak for the motion. There is no space for peace into perfectionism in a priority. Perfectionism is not as the same thing as striving to be your best. Perfectionism is not about thing achievement and growth. Detrimental means causing damage to health. The pressure of having perfection in every activity or event causes a lot of tension and worry, which spoils our mental as well as physical health. It is better to do every work with satisfaction and genuine effort than taking excessive pressure that damages our health. You have to write accordingly. Sometimes we become so nervous that we even fail to do, but we can do as per our capacity. It deteriorates our health more. Perfectionism is often seen as a positive trait that increases your chances of success, but it can lead to deficient thoughts or behavior that make it harder to achieve goals. It may also cause stress, anxiety, depression, and other mental issues. People who strive for perfection out of feelings of inadequacy or failure may find it helpful to speak with a therapist. This can often help people excessive self-criticism. Even when people with perfectionism traits get this desired results, they may still be unsatisfied. This may feel that if they truly were perfect, they would not have had to work too hard to achieve their goals. Spending 30 minutes writing and rewriting a 2-sentence email, believing that missing 2 points on a test is a sign of failure, difficulty being happy for others who are successful. Many factors can contribute to whether perfection develops. A few include frequent fear of disappointment from others or feelings of insecurity and inadequacy. Mental health issues like anxiety or obsessive compulsive disorder. Perfectionism can severely impact our mental and physical health. In a recent study conducted by Thomas Curran, a lecturer in the Department for Health at University of Bath in the United Kingdom, and Andrew P. Hill of New York, St. John University also is the UK, the authors explain that socially prescribed perfectionism is the most debilitating of three forms. In socially prescribed perfection, individuals believe their social context is exclusively demanding, that others fudge they harshly, and that they must display perfection to secure disapproval. Perfectionism oververges on self-abuse. Perfectionism are hugely hard on themselves, says Professor Havid in another interview, with a hatred that is breathing at times. Toxic perfectionism seems to hit young people particularly hard. According to recent estimates, almost 30% of ungraduated students experience symptoms of depression, and perfectionism has been widely associated with these symptoms. To lessen perfectionism, it may help to set realistic, attainable goals, back up overwhelming tasks into small steps, focus on one activity or task at a time, acknowledge that everyone makes mistakes, recognize the most mistakes present learning opportunities, confront fears of failures by remaining realistic about possible outcomes. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Mehak, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yeah, it seemed you were reading from the text, from the, you know, whatever page or whatever you had with you. It seemed like that. So anyway, we'll discuss that later. Right? It seemed you were reading it out. Okay, let's go on then.
Yes, ma'am. Everyone is please requested to strictly adhere to the time limit. The time limit is 3 minutes. I now invite the speaker from team VB05 who will be speaking against the motion, Narmata Bhatt. I request the speakers from VB06 to be ready.
Dear teachers, honorable judges, and my dear friends, I hope you all are doing great. Today, I, Narmata Bhatt of class 11, is going to present my views against the motion of the topic, that is, the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. I think perfectionism can be defined as a personal standard attitude or philosophy that demands perfection and rejects anything less. It is a very healthy attitude. It is a relentless striving for extremely high goals. Due to perfectionism, our confidence boosts up and we are able to face difficult challenges of our life enthusiastically with proper insight and cognizance. Due to perfectionism, positive trait of hard work and determination can turn into an overwhelming desire of please and overachieve. Also, perfectionism is detrimental. Instead, it enforces us to improve ourselves to reach the maximum ability of achieving perfectionism in our performance. It encourages us to give our best in every activity or work that is assigned to us. Can anybody tell me, without perfectionism, will anybody be concerned to give their best? I think no. They will be concerned to be good in every activity, but they will not give their 100% and will never be able to measure their capability. I think perfectionism is not bad at all. The positive side of perfectionism is when you have ambitious drive towards success. The individuals who engage themselves in the race of perfectionism achieve the high and impossible goals. Also, without perfectionism, exceptions around the goals are impossibly rigid. With the help of perfectionism, when we strive for high goals and achieve that, and that time the feeling we get gives us the self-satisfaction and increases our self-esteem. With the help of perfectionism, it helps to match our energy and time to the task that is assigned that matches our strength and interest. At last, I want to end my debate with a quote that choose to achieve perfectionism. We can't achieve perfectionism, no. But if we choose to achieve perfectionism, we can achieve excellence, we can achieve our targets, and we can achieve our goals. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
Thank you, VB05. Well spoken. Next, I invite Soha Khan from team VB06, who will be speaking for the motion.
So in order to debate this motion more effectively, let me first start off by telling you what my opposition is trying to support. My opposition is not fighting for a methodological process of achieving mental stability. Rather, they're trying to grant legitimacy to an ideological position that causes depression, anxiety disorders, eating disorders, and addictive behaviors. My opposition are not a bunch of humanists that they're going to project themselves as. Rather, they're victims of this age-old structure which have unfortunately induced this absurd notion that the pressure of perfectionism is not detrimental for our mental health. A very good morning to all of you. Today, I, Soha Khan, stand before you to completely agree with the belief of the house that the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. Today, from the other side, we've witnessed a mixture of cherry-picked quotes, facts and figures, self-serving, selective, a farrago of distortions, misrepresentations, misquotations, and misinterpretations. But I have nothing to worry about, because I'm sure that by the end of this debate, every rational person will be convinced that my opposition's debate has been nothing but a poorly crafted rhetoric full of immaturity. Now, my argument analyzes how an individual first develops this need to be perfect and how failure to achieve this image where they are able to handle the pressure of being a perfectionist often induces guilt, which they constantly try to do away with. Firstly, talking about Lacan's mirror stage theory, which talked about how an individual quickly develops this ability to recognize themselves in reflective surfaces, which produces a psychic response, giving rise to the mental representation of an I and the other. The process of self-identification allows the child to not only develop ego, but also the infant begins to resonate with the perfect other within this progression. Identifying one's own specular image as the other is in itself a fundamentally self-alienating process, wherein they completely devoid themselves of the I and induce certain narcissistic tendencies in themselves in order to seek the other. Despite actively trying to achieve the other, it instigates a certain sense of guilt within them because A, they are not able to withstand the pressure which one constantly endures in the pursuit of achieving this perfection, and B, because they lose the I while trying to achieve this other. Due to the sense of guilt, they create this illusion around themselves wherein they believe that they are able to contend with the pressure of being a perfectionist, and through that are able to go away with the guilt of not being able to withstand the pressure. These frames of illusion within which the individual has been juxtaposed due to the certain interaction with the truth, the contorted illusion which is hypothesized by the individual breaks, and the individual now has to suffer through this intrinsic guilt of not being able to handle the pressure of being a perfectionist. This often places the individual in a dilemma wherein they're not able to gain some form of semblance with the illusion and massaged by them, which makes them lose contact with the superego and come in consonance with their id. As soon as this happens, they inevitably are subjected to various forms of mental disorders and suicidal thoughts, etc. Due to all of these reasons, we proudly rest our case.
Thank you.
Quite an eloquent argument. I now invite Taruni Handu from Team VB06. Who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, Team VB07, is requested to be prepared.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are.
Yes.
Please continue.
A very good morning to all of you. My name is Taruni Handu. The motion for today states the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. And I completely stand against it. Since it is my belief that perfectionism has positive connotations which cannot be subsided, and during the course of this debate, I will be proving that. Let me start my argument by stating that pressure of any kind, if not handled appropriately, can become a burden for most of us. It is the pursuit of perfectionism, if not perfectionism itself, that has led humankind to a level that we are at right now. And let me just call this pursuit a pursuit of excellence, to get rid of the baggage of what sounds like an unrealistic mad race. The pursuit, to me, is a journey that most of us seek to undertake. A journey to strive for perfection at a skill you intrinsically want to master, and not about killing yourself in the process. It is about preserving the asset that someday will exemplify that excellence. Imagine our world where our role models gave up on their pursuits of perfection because of the so-called mental pressure of it. Aircraft designers compromising on perfection, the artisans of Taj Mahal feeling the pressure of making it perfect, or Mozart not practicing hard enough to create the symphonies that he did. Nadia Comaneci, often seen as synonymous with perfection because of her perfect 10 score at the Montreal Olympics, talked about wanting to reach the stars through sheer hard work and perseverance. And perfection doesn't stop at Nadia. In different fields and by different people, it is being pursued by individuals and groups with as much fervor as Nadia did. We often hear people associating perfectionism with mental health issues. Although in reality, perfectionism is hardly ever the root cause for that. The term perfection itself has turned adverse in the minds of people, and we just refuse to see its positive traits. Research actually proves that healthy perfectionism leads to higher levels of self-esteem, endurance, satisfaction, and so on. People tend to idealize perfectionists, which boosts their confidence, resulting in a positive impact on their mental health. Without the pursuit of perfectionism or excellence, we would end up in a world full of mediocrity. It is because people have set benchmarks and pushed the boundaries that we know that there are no boundaries on human endeavors. Humankind would still be believing that 4 minutes for a mile barrier was insurmountable until the British athlete Roger Bannister in 1954 told the world that it wasn't. Bannister or Nadia didn't let the pressure of reaching out to the stars pull them down. And we as well shouldn't let that happen to us. With that being said, I rest my case. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Taruni.
Great work, Team VB06. Now we have Team VB07. I request the speaker for the motion, Ishmeet Kaur, to please turn on her video.
Can you see me and hear me clearly?
Yes, Ishmeet.
Shall I start with my video?
Yeah.
A Korean pop star shocks his fans by ending his life. Arjun Sharma, JEE advanced, All India ranked 6th, commits suicide. I'm sure these news headlines ring a bell. In both these cases, the victims considered themselves a failure as they were unsuccessful in achieving perfection. Is this the price we need to pay as we strive for perfectionism? Is being perfect more valuable than being alive? Good morning to one and all today. I, Ishmeet Kaur, will speak for the motion, the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. Perfectionism is characterized by a person's desire to strive for flawlessness and is accompanied by severe critical self-evaluation. According to many psychologists, there is no empirical support for the assertion that a healthy form of perfectionism exists. For some people, the line between achieving excellence and reaching perfection is quite hazy. Excellence is an attempt to perform a task in the best way possible, whereas perfection is the definitive 100% right way of doing anything. Excellence is openness to being wrong, whereas perfectionism is having to be right at everything one does. Is it really possible? I want you to imagine a little boy who's learning to walk. He takes his first step, then toddles a bit and finally falls down. Let us assume his mother is a perfectionist. And instead of encouraging and appreciating her child, she scolds him. And seeing the futility of the process, doesn't let him walk again. All of us would agree that it is obvious that an infant would toddle and fall in the process. Well, why does this understanding disappear when we try to learn other things in life? Because this is what perfectionism does to us. It limits us and doesn't let us grow as to learn we need to make mistakes. Perfectionism may lead to psychological disorders like depression, anxiety, OCD, and at times even suicidal attempts. Hence, I want to ask you, why do we choose perfectionism when we can opt for excellence? Why can't we laugh at our own fall, get up, meander, giggle, and learn the walk of life? Why don't we let go of this illusion called perfectionism when our mere existence is the result of errors in the copying of the DNA? With this, I rest my case. Thank you.
Thank you.
A very interesting argument. I now invite Yashaswini Dagar from Team VB07, who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, Team VB08, is requested to be prepared for their turn.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you
yes,
are.
Yashaswini.
Once upon a time, not so long ago, a schoolgirl commits suicide. After much head scratching and mumbling, instead of concluding the obvious that the girl had a weak coping mechanism for stress and failure, our learned beards put the blame on the pressure of perfectionism, thereby tarnishing the reputation of a much sought after and desirable entity, perfectionism. The truth is that it is the inability of individuals to perform under pressure and not perfectionism itself which is damaging to their mental health. Good morning, respected judges, teachers, and my worthy opponents. Today, I, Yashaswini Dagar, am here to speak against the motion, the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. Our society has carved a distorted image of perfectionism thanks to a plethora of theories and opinions of psychologists. Perfectionism means refusal to accept any standard short of perfection. Going by this definition, perfectionism doesn't seem to be as bad as we paint it. In fact, if humans hadn't been striving for perfection across history, what would our lives be like? If you look at all the technological advancements that have been made, starting from the discovery of the proton right up to artificial intelligence, do you think all this would have been possible without striving for perfection? We all look up to doctors and surgeons because they save lives. Is that not because they are committed to the drive for perfection? Perfectionism is an integral part of some professions, like the military. Imagine if our soldiers went to war with half-baked plans of attack and lackadaisical training. Would that be an army you would trust to keep you safe? Striving for perfection isn't something to be feared. And to those who do, I say it isn't the pressure of perfectionism, but our weakness and indolence which can kill us. The drive for achieving more, for pushing the boundaries, is part of our inherent nature. And why wouldn't it be, when even our bodies are the most precise and complex machines in existence? The blood pumping through our veins and the millions of signals being fired through our brains at this very second teaches just one thing. To live is to aim for perfection. I would like to conclude by saying that the same water softens a potato but hardens an egg. Needless to say, water is not to be blamed. With this, I rest my case. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well spoken, team VB07. Next up is team VB08. I invite Kanika Rajput, who will be speaking for the motion.
Am I visible and audible?
Yes. Kanika.
So here is the uncomfortable truth about perfection. It's often just insecurity disguised. It's a dangerous state of mind in an imperfect world. Good afternoon, everyone present here. I, Kanika, present before you, completely emphasizing, upholding, and supporting the motion. You know, striving for excellence feels wonderful because you're trying your very best. But pursuit of perfectionism can feel terrible because your work is somehow never quite good enough. Perfectionism is often seen as a positive trait that increases your chances of success, but I see it as one of the most toxic traits that leads to all the self-depriving thoughts one has. Toxic perfectionism seems to the youth particularly hard. According to the estimates, 30% of undergraduates experience the symptom of depression, and pursuit of perfectionism is highly associated with these symptoms. Some highly successful individuals have also agreed to the fact that you don't have to be a perfectionist to achieve great things in your life. Steve Jobs' pursuit of perfectionism is legendary, but it's his take on failure, which may be more notable. He believed that when you innovate, you make mistakes and fail. And a perfectionist wouldn't have suffered these failures. Another great example is Pablo Picasso. He realized that you don't have to be a perfectionist. He realized perfectionism isn't the point. You all don't have to be a Picasso to realize that. Raising perfectionism doesn't mean each generation is getting more accomplished. It means we're getting sicker, sadder, and even undermining our own potential. According to the data compiled by the National Crime Record Bureau India, we lose one great person per hour and almost 28 suicides are reported each day. We never know how raising perfectionism can cause someone's mental well-being and subsequently their lives. So I would like to quote that true perfectionists aren't really trying to be perfect, they're avoiding not being good enough. So honorable jury, let me conclude by saying that the people who deem themselves perfectionists, on the other hand, are not driven by the pursuit of perfectionism, they're driven by the avoidance of failure. So pursuit of perfectionism must be completely ruled out from our work culture to ensure a healthy and happy generation. Thank you.
Thank you, Kanika.
Thank you, Kanika. I now invite the speaker from team VB08 speaking against the motion, Pranshita Sharma. I request the speakers from team VB09 to be ready.
Persistence, perfection,
far. Prioritizing your passion, it keeps you sane. Good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Pranshita, code VB08, present before you all to speak against the motion. The pressure of perfectionism is not detrimental, but beneficial to mental health. Perfectionism is not about doing the job without making mistake. It is about striving to achieve, master, and grow to be better at anything. Human beings evolve because someone has improvised and strived to make things perfect. Complacency is the enemy of progress. Stress can be good. People perform better when there are deadlines or parameters. It is called eustress. Eustress is good because it brings out the best in a person. A person who manages his time well keeps his work one step ahead towards less stress and perfection. Perfectionists are comparatively more hardworking and determined. They can work for more longer hours and can pay attention to the smallest detail of the task assigned to them. Their level of ambition is also very high. Perfectionism encourages us to achieve unexpected goals. It increases our level of perseverance and can lead to world-class performance. Having high standards is good, and striving for quality is admirable. A perfect person may be an ideal for others. Setting attainable goals, breaking overwhelming tasks into small steps, and focusing on one task at a time are few steps for attaining perfectionism. In fact, striving for perfectionism brings joy. There wouldn't be a Vishwanathan Anand or Sachin Tendulkar without striving to perfect one's skill. There wouldn't be an electrical bulb or telephone if Alva Edison or Graham Bell gave up in the first attempt. These exemplary men, whose names are written in golden history, were not known because of any psychological disorder. Therefore, respectable jury, if the work culture is robbed of the pursuit of perfection, then we will become a complacent society heading nowhere. Perfectionism is marked detrimental by those who do not share the same passion. Perfectionism is often seen as a non-mistake-making trait, but in reality, it is the exact opposite of it. It is not an illusion. Of course, perfectionism can be attained if a person is self-forgiving and self-encouraging. I strongly but respectfully dissent the motion.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well spoken, Team VB08. Next, I invite Shlok Sangarpal from Team VB09, who will be speaking for the motion.
I hope I'm audible and visible.
Yes.
Yes, Shlok.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Shlok Sangarpal, with Team Core VB09, will be speaking for the motion. Before I begin, let us think of a scenario where Mr. Smith, a perfectionist, who has become a laughing joke among his colleagues. The reason? He spends 3/4 of an hour writing and rewriting a 2-sentence email, no matter the content, no matter who's being sent to. One can well imagine the futility of Mr. Smith's actions, considering the amount of time wasted and the amount of work that gets piled up during that time. Brené Brown, a research professor at the University of Houston, explains that perfectionism is used by people as a shield to protect themselves against the pain of blame, judgment, and shame. Research has identified 2 distinctive types of perfectionism: excellence seeking and failure avoiding. Excellence-seeking perfectionists not only stringently evaluate their own performance, but also hold high performance expectations for other people in their lives. Instead of being proud of their progress, learning, or hard work, they might constantly compare their work to the work of others or fixate on achieving flawless output. And the second, failure-avoiding perfectionism involves an obsessive concern with and an aversion to failing to reach high performance standards. People belonging to this constantly worry that their work is not quite right or good enough and believe that they will lose respect of others if they don't come out as perfect. This triggers critical self-evaluation, the consequences of which are high levels of burnout, stress, workaholism, anxiety, and depression. Gordon Flett and Paul Hewitt, 2 leading authorities in the field of perfectionism, define the 3 main facets of perfectionism in a landmark study they published 3 decades ago. According to this study, perfectionism is of 3 types: self-oriented, other-oriented, and socially prescribed perfection, with socially prescribed being the most debilitating of them all. Before going ahead, I would like to ask a question to all my worthy opponents here. Don't our imperfections make us human? By practicing perfectionism, aren't we stripping away the only thing that makes us human, In the book Steve Jobs, Jobs' wife, Lauren Powell, commented on Jobs' obsession with perfectionism and said it took them 8 years to buy a sofa. Another example is the tennis star Serena Williams, a self-claimed perfectionist who breaks rackets and casts blame when things go wrong and cost her the game. As many as 2 in 5 kids and adolescents are perfectionists, says Katie Rasmussen, the research development of child development perfection at West Virginia University. Perfectionist children avoid playing a game or trying new activities with friends for fear of showing up as less than perfect. The rise in perfectionism doesn't mean each generation is becoming more accomplished. It means we're getting sicker, sadder, and even undermining our own potential. I would like to conclude with a quote I came across a few days ago. Being 80% effective is more significant than the paralysis that intercepts the 100% perfection. Thank you.
Thank you, Shlok.
Well argued. I invite Anika Rana from Team VB09, who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, Team VB10, is requested to be prepared.
Am I audible and respectful, everyone?
Yes, please.
Okay. As I saw the jets of fire spewing out from the base of the craft, heard the roaring engine come to life, and watched the rocket ascend into the sky from the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, I thought to myself, what goes behind such an impeccable launch? The answer is simple, perfection. From selecting the rocket model to considering each and every external constraint, no parameter can go unperfected, and there's no scope of error. Let's consider another example. We've all seen the brave army personnel. They go through rigorous training, putting their bodies and their minds under immense stress and pressure so that they're equipped to combat any critical challenges at hand. In other words, by working hard towards perfection, they strengthen and fortify their minds. A very warm good morning to each and every one of you present here. My examples are just the basis of my argument, for I, Anika Rana, stand strongly against the motion that the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental to our mental health. And in the following points, I would endeavor to prove my stance. A global study of 42,000 young people has shown that over the last 30 years, the levels of perfectionism have risen. Surely this couldn't be just coincidental. Most of the accomplished people have reached their standing because they can weaponize their internal pressure and utilize it as a constructive asset to do or to get their jobs done more efficiently and effectively. Their perfectionism allows them to deliver world-class performance. And these diligent people are often found to possess unmatched mental prowess. Psychologists say that perfectionists compared to others have higher levels of motivation and conscientious attitude, making them better students and employees. My opponents have said that perfectionism is linked with increasing levels of mental health issues, but I would like to clarify, correlation does not equal causation. Perhaps this internal pressure, this motivator, is not at the root cause of our mental disorders. Rather, it's the external factors from our society. With pressure, the stakes are higher, the excitement is heightened, and the aftermath satisfying. I would like to ask you all, would we have those great politicians, commandos, scientists, professors, if everyone just shied away from perfection? Or would we have those inventions and discoveries that better our lives daily, not the great minds who dared to strive for perfection? Simply observe nature. We have all read about it in our science books. Carbon molecules, when exposed to extreme heat and pressure, crystallize, and then eventually a diamond is formed. So when we want success, when we want more than just survival, when we want to shine, the pressure of perfectionism is a requisite. With that, I rest my case.
Thank you.
Work team VB09. Next, we have team VB10. I request the speaker for the Manasvi Rawat to please turn on her video.
Am I perfectly visible and audible, everyone?
Yes, Manasvi.
Okay then. So I shall start now.
a renowned 27-year-old Korean pop star Kim Jong-hyun ends his life. 30-year-old Indian model and actress Kuljeet Randhawa commits suicide. 25-year-old Kannada television actress Saujanya hangs herself to death. Also young and veterans in their respective fields. Then what has made them to take this extreme step? Yes, my worthy opponents, it's all because of the mental illness and depression they were suffering from due to the extreme pressure of becoming perfect. A very good afternoon to respected teachers, honorable judges, and my worthy opponents. Today, I'm Manasvi Rawat. I'm here to express my views in support of the motion, the pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for our mental health. Perfectionism is indeed the self-abuse of the highest order. The urge to be the best is driving all to push themselves so hard that it is becoming life-threatening at times. Celebrities in the showbiz, to give that confident performance on stage, are taking drugs and they don't even realize about the consequence of stance abuse. Models and actresses to possess that so-called perfect beauty, to have that perfect pout, bosom, or a nose job, don't even think twice before going under the knife. And are my worthy opponents aware that more than 70% of young people who have committed suicide were in the habit of creating exceedingly high expectations of themselves? Not just adults, but sadly, children are also falling prey to this modern disease of perfectionism. From doping in sports to insecurities among children, perfectionism's pressure is predominant among every age group and in every field, as everybody wants to be in the rat race. Let me tell you, a fifth year grade student was moved to tears because she received an A- in her report card. Can you believe it? Can any of us believe it? Not at all, but this is the case. She had learned to believe that the only way of receiving love and appreciation is by being a high achiever. There is always a housewife who wants a perfectly clean and organized home and would never realize about the obsessive compulsive disorder that she faces. And on top of this, some people believe that perfectionism is a healthy motivation. However, perfectionism is a deadly poison, extremely toxic to our mental and emotional health. I firmly believe that we are humans. God didn't mean us to be perfect. And on this note, I would conclude by saying that the essence of human beings is its self-imperfection, and we need to learn that. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you.
A very informed argument, thank you. I now invite Khushi Rawat from team VB10, who will be speaking against the motion. The next team, VB11, is requested to prepare for their turn.
Am I audible?
Yes, Khushi.
Yes.
I'll start. John Henry Newman once said, "To live is to change, and to be perfect is to have changed often." A very good morning to everyone. Today, I, Khushi of Code VB10, is going to speak against the motion on the topic, "The pressure of perfectionism is detrimental for mental health." We all are aware how different our generation is, that we are not going to do anything unless we have a pressure to do it. How we all are texting our friends whole day, "I need motivation." Perfectionism is that motivation. If you have a clear vision on your mind regarding what you want, you will be quite motivated to work as hard as possible to be the better version of yourself, to push through the difficult periods of your life. And that's what perfectionism is. It's very kind of us to tell ourselves that just accept the way you are, accept your flaws. But why? If you can strive to be the better version of yourself, why not prefer that? How can the world, the humans, will make progress if they have this tendency to accept their flaws? Why not overcome this flaw? Why not have the motive to do more and more every day? To have a reason to get up every morning to be the best, the perfect version of ourselves? Then I read somewhere that perfectionists tend to fear failures and rejection. I think everyone fear it, or everyone should fear it. I don't think any one of us will be okay failing our exams. You will not just accept that failure and continue enjoying your life. You will work hard and hard every day to overcome that failure. And maybe next time you get a 50, but you won't stop there because obviously you want the best. And maybe the next time you get the perfect 100,
And that will be the moment where you will be the happiest, your parents being proud of you, and you will shine. And that's how life goes on. Notice how we all get so happy when we make a perfect circle or a perfect chapati, or when our paintings come out as the perfect piece. The colors are perfectly blended. We drew both the eyes perfectly same. There is definitely happiness that is obviously good for our mental health by doing things in a perfect manner without any flaws, without any mistakes. The road of being perfect or doing things perfectly is maybe full of ups and downs. But in the end, the minute of perfectionism was worth the effort. Because remember, we are doing it for ourselves, for our private life to be perfect, not for the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Khushi.
Well spoken, team VB10. Next up is team VB11. I invite Riza Sharma, who will be speaking for the motion.
I am audible and visible, right?
Yes, Reza.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, what is perfection? Well, the dictionary says a condition, state or quality of being free from all flaws or defects. But let me rephrase it as a 10-letter word that describes a utopian something, unrealistic and unreasonable, that doesn't even exist. Greetings to one and all present. Today, I, Reza Sharma, am here to put forth my views in support of the motion. Ladies and gentlemen, in course of my speech, I will prove before you all that perfectionism and pressure go hand in hand. And yes, it affects our mental health adversely. Before I go on, let me clarify. I'm not blind to the fact that the urge to be perfect motivates us to be our best. In some ways, it is synonymous with success. But behind all those A+ and perfect 10 on 10s, it has a darker side too, which is the case for the majority who get deceived in the rut for perfection and eventually suffer. We all agree it's a tough world out there where only the strong survives. And that exactly is my point. 1.5 lakh students prepared for JEE Advanced this year, with just about a mere 17,000 seats in all the IITs. So imagine the heartbreak of those who gave their all out, tried to be better than their best, and yet were left high and dry. The work sector of our country, where one is told every single day that even the best is not good enough, and if you do not deliver, fired. And the result? Long working hours. You give up your sleep, your health, your social life, running after a mirage till you break down. People with OCD can be termed as strict perfectionists. Their motto? Be perfect. And that, my friends, is not something they choose, but something their own anxiety compels them to do. Rates of cosmetic surgery have seen a rise of 81.4% in just 2 decades. Why? To look perfect. The problem with the obsession for perfection is that we aren't aware that it's related to our caliber and external circumstances, which aren't always conducive. So you may end up like the poor nightingale in the poem The Frog and the Nightingale, who under pressure from the frog to get better at singing, trains harder and harder, finally bursts away and dies. There's a Japanese tradition called kintsugi. When an object breaks, they fill the gaps and the cracks with powdered gold, as they believe in the philosophy of embracing the imperfect and then making it all the more beautiful. So I say, love your cracks. Stop aspiring to be a perfect person, because the truth, ladies and gentlemen, is that real people aren't perfect. And perfect people aren't real. So what do you choose? With this, I rest my case. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A good perspective. I now invite the speaker from team VB11 speaking against the motion, Anukriti Chaturvedi. I request the speakers from team VB12 to please be ready.
Am I visible and audible?
Yes, Anukriti.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. In a race, only one gets to hold the trophy. While thousands may compete but end up clapping for the winner, this life of ours is not a bed of roses. We live in a highly competitive dog-eat-dog world where only the fittest survives at the end of the day. So can we even afford to be anything short of being perfect if we don't want to be left behind in the race of life?
Bombay.
Greetings to everyone. I, Anukriti Chaturvedi, will be speaking against the motion, and I can say this with conviction that of poor mental health. Ladies and gentlemen, if any kind of measure.
Excuse me, there's just pause. There's a lot of background noise.
Ma'am, it's not coming from my end.
I think it's from the school.
Yeah. Ma'am, it's not coming from my end.
I think it's
coming from somebody named Shelly Mishra, if I'm not wrong. Yeah. So maybe request everybody to their audio on mute and only the speaker to please carry on. Yes. Thank you.
Ma'am, should I start from the beginning?
You can start again. Yes.
Yes, Adukriti.
Okay. In a race, only one gets to hold the trophy. While thousands may compete but end up clapping for the winner. This life of ours is not a bed of roses. We live in a highly competitive dog-eat-dog world where only the fittest survives at the end of the day. So can we even afford to do anything short of being perfect if we don't want to be left behind in the race of life? Greetings to everyone. I, Anukriti Chaturvedi, will be speaking against the motion, and I can say this with conviction that perfectionism can never be the cause of poor mental health. Ladies and gentlemen, if any kind of pressure would push one towards perfection and towards achieving what one wants, isn't it actually a positive pressure, which I would like to modify as a positive energy that drives the person to do his best? Then tell me, how can it be detrimental to mental health? And are we not facing pressure at every stage of our life? From learning to walk as an infant, to getting a perfect score in boards, to getting the best college with cutoffs as high as 100, to having the best job. Remember, only the finest get these luxuries, and there is no scope for neo-perfects. I would like to clarify to the opposition here that journey to perfectionism becomes pressurizing only when we are not meticulous in our planning, preparation, and execution. NASA failed more than 50 times in their Mars missions and were only able to succeed when their design was perfect. Chandrayaan 2 failed and Vikram lander crashed on Moon because of an imperfect software code. Even if one brick is misplaced while building a house, the whole structure would collapse. So sometimes perfectionism is not a choice, rather a necessity. Perfectionism depends on person to person, their mindsets and their goals. We as humans are bound to limits, which can only be broken when we aim for perfection. Otherwise, we can say goodbye to innovation and betterment. Cars in this era of AI and technology can't be designed better, and yet they are being evolved and better versions are being bought because perfectionism is being aimed. Let me also take the example of Neeraj Chopra, who weighed over 90 kgs but worked on himself for more than 7 years, and now he has brought in the chest of every Indian with his Olympic gold. All such sports persons, artists, entrepreneurs, more closer to home, JEE, NEET, and civil services aspirants, keep pushing their bar higher. Burn the midnight oil and turn 24 into 48 hours. Also, gather the mental strength and stamina in the process that keeps them from wilting under the pressure. And that's what takes them to the zenith of glory and achievement. A pressure cooker cooks the best food under optimum pressure. It looks ready to burst, but that is when it produces the best results. Only those who have the grit to pass through the test by fire would eventually enjoy the exhilaration of victory. So are you ready to join me in the march towards perfection? I take your leave. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well spoken, Team VB11. Now I invite Devanshi from Team VB12, who will be speaking for the motion.
Good day, everyone. I'm Devanshi, and I'm here today to have a little talk about perfectionism. So when we talk about perfectionism, the first thing that comes to my mind is procrastination, actually. While this may seem ironic, procrastination is a recurring issue. Perfectionist tends to conjure up an immanipulate vision of how things should be. They are specific about having perfect conditions before they get to work. Perfectionists have a precise, extreme view of how every piece of work should look. They exhaust themselves emotionally and extend a large amount of time just to achieve that final goal. Perfectionists tend to have a deep-seated unhappiness. Perfectionism creates a great struggle and unhappiness for themselves too. They struggle with their do's and don'ts, yet they refuse to ask for help. They set high sky expectations for their work, yet they procrastinate with their tasks. They want to achieve perfection in everything, yet the perfection creates a great unhappiness for themselves too. Extreme perfectionism combined with low self-worth and a firm refusal to seek help may lead to suicide or actions that lead to the slow death. In a study in Sweden, 383 people were found that perfectionism is correlated with a degree of sleeping problems and even cardiovascular diseases. So, in the conclusion, I would like to say there is nothing wrong with aiming high, but shooting for perfection should cause you to feel inspired, not anxious. In fact, research suggests that people who are motivated by desire or to impress others are worse than those who are simply setting goals for themselves. If you drive yourself hard mainly because you are worried what others will see you as less than perfect, consider disregarding those impossibly high expectations and working towards getting good enough. Your quirks and even your little mistakes infuse your work with personality. Thank you.
Thank you, Devanshi. Again, it seemed you were reading it out. It seemed like that.
Yeah, that's
we'll discuss that later.
Too. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's go on.
Quite an articulate argument. Last but not the least, I invite Ayushi Jori from team BB12, who will be speaking against the motion.
Greetings of the day, everyone. I, Ayushi, from the team BB12, is going to discuss about against the motion. I agree what Devanshi said, but perfectionism can help us to increase our overall motivation, making us to strive the best version of ourselves, taking things to the next level, and becoming idols for people, giving us happiness and self-satisfaction. Paying attention to details, spending a lot of time on the things. That is the thing that leads to the biggest discoveries we see in the current world. So the hard work involved never goes in vain. The data of Sweden was indeed an issue to look after, but there are many personalities like Mark Zuckerberg, Mukesh Ambani, Tata Birla, Mahatma Gandhi, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Amitabh Bachchan, and K-pop groups like BTS and Blackpink. They had the mindset to work, to become perfectionists. And indeed, now they are the most respectful and successful personalities and are the idols of thousands and millions of people. There are two types of perfectionism, the good kind and the bad kind. We have to be the good one. The one who always tries, the one who expects themselves to do well, the one who takes failures as an opportunity to work more better in future. We have to be the one. We have to be the achievers with high standards of excellence. We have to be positive and support all the people around us and people who are trying to be perfectionists. And we should never give up. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Greatly done, team BB12. With this, we come to the conclusion of today's debate. I thank everyone for maintaining the decorum of the event. While the results are being compiled, let's have a look at a beautiful performance brought to us by the music and dance department of our school. In a beautiful state of Kashmir, after the long, harsh winters, people welcome the arrival of the lovely spring season with joy and enthusiasm by performing a traditional folk dance. Girls in colorful dresses gather in orchards and perform roof to melodious and rhythmic songs. So let's enjoy nature in its bloom and sway to the rhythm of roof.
Thank you.
What a captivating performance. May I now please invite Ms. Vartika Mishra to please share her views on the event.
Busy with yes,
we are a little busy,
judging today's event. I'm sure it must be very, very challenging for you as
it
well.
Was,
and so we are quite eager now to listen your viewpoint. Over to you, ma'am.
So it is very challenging. We are still, you know, going through the sheet, and while Shubha does that, and I can, you know, speak to the students. So it was actually a very eye-opening and insightful debate for me today as well. I also, you know, realized what students think and how are they, you know, what direction they are going in. And it is a very difficult task to decide who will win. You know, it is really a challenge for us, for both of us. So meanwhile, Shubha is working on her sheet, what I have to say for students of today is that, you know, you need to have a goal. You need to have a larger picture in mind, you know, that this is what I want to achieve. This is where I want to see myself, let's say, you know, 10 years afterwards, you know. You have to design your life accordingly. Whether, you know, I want to be, you know, working in UN, doing a project on education, or whether I'm working in Goldman Sachs, I'm a financial advisor, or, you know, I'm a biochemist working in a pharmaceutical company, or I'm a researcher, or I'm a Kathak dancer. So whatever your dream or vision is, you know, in life, you need to have at least one dream in your life. You know, you might, your dreams or visions or goals might keep changing, you know, but you need to have something in mind, you know, which will keep you going, right? And if people don't have a purpose in life, then, you know, you go astray, you find out new ways to, you know, pass your time, you get bored. So it is very important to have a dream, but don't make that dream inflexible, you know, that you cannot change, that I have decided today that I am going to become this, so I will become this. And if I'm not able to get into this particular university or a school or a company organization, then, you know, it is the end of the world. Sky is going to fall and I'm just going to crash. I won't want to live, you know. These are the things which are detrimental. And you know, there's no, I mean, happiness is always inside. You can't seek happiness outside at all. So it is all about fulfillment. You know, success and happiness, these are two things which are so different from each other. Success is how others see you. You know, you have a big car, you have a, you know, big house, you are doing, you know, you're going to Europe for holidays. So that is what you're showing to the world. What you're projecting is success. But success and happiness are very different things. Happiness is fulfillment. What makes you, you know, calm and content, and, you know, you're happy to stay in one place. That is fulfillment. You know, I think success for me will be what I am able to do and what choices I have. And if I am able to do, if I want to meet somebody, I can go and meet. If I want to not meet somebody, I'll avoid that. So the choice which I have of doing something or not doing something is success for me, right? If I am forced to do something, you know, even if I don't like doing it, even if I don't want to do it, but I'm forced because I need to earn money, I need to listen to my boss shouting at me, you know, that is not success for me. So I should have the choice. So, yeah, right? So success is different, happiness is different, and you have to see what you feel is success for you, okay? And what do you feel is failure for you? And what you feel is success for others? If you want success for others, if you want others to see success, you successful, then you will, you know, go in for the rat race, big cars, big houses and all that. But if you want success for yourself, the content, the fulfillment, that is what you have to search for. And if you're searching for that contentment and fulfillment, then you will never overdo things. You will never stretch yourself. You will know yourself. You will know your inner strength. And you will work on your strengths. Okay? So this is my message for the students. And if Shubha has done her sheet, then I think I can go on to do mine. Shubha?
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your perspective. Mm-hmm. And I think it's, you know, like each one of us is coming up, you know, with the different perspective on the same topic. So mm-hmm. I guess it's going to help someone out there, right? So, you know, while the result is being compiled, you know, let's have like an open discussion. So anyone is welcome to come and give his or her viewpoint on the topic. So we have some teachers also, you know, from participating schools who have joined us. So I request if any one of you would like to, you know, share your opinion, or any of one of our management members, any participant, you know. So it'll be nice.
Yeah, Rupinder, we have principals from our sister branches. They can also participate.
Yes, ma'am. I request, we have principals, you know, from our sister concerns as well. So
sister,
we would request if any one of you would like to, you know, share your perspective on the topic, most welcome. The floor is open.
Good afternoon.
Great. So we have Mahendri ma'am. Yeah, Principal Greater Noida from our great Vishwabhati. Welcome, Mahendri ma'am. Thank you so much.
So we'd love to hear your perspective, ma'am.
Yeah, I've been watching right from the beginning. So it was wonderful listening to all the speakers, and the topic is very pertinent on today's date when every one of us, you know, are in a rat race. And but then somewhere I have a feeling that if we leave out the pursuit of perfection from our work culture, we are going to be very laid back and complacent. So, but then if we take in the right attitude, I mean, I got to do the best I can, and can I do it a bit better? That's a question we need to keep asking ourselves again and again, whether we are students or professionals. Okay, this is the best I've done. Can I do it a little better? Can I stretch myself? But then, if I have the right mental attitude, that I'm not going to let it, you know, make me sick. Not that I'm going to spend sleepless nights after it. I suppose we will strike a balance where we will definitely head towards perfection, advance towards, not, you know, kind of cause a kind of mental pressure, which is going to be an impediment in my on my way to progress. So this is what we have to counsel our children today. Because if you say you stop striving for perfection, you're somewhere teaching them to be satisfied, you know, with the chalpaya attitude, which I say isn't the way of work. That is my take on it.
Thank you, Mahendri ma'am. Rupinder?
Ma'am. So thank you so much, Mahendri ma'am. I think your perspective was also very, very interesting. What you, you know, you're trying to propagate is that one should, you know, not be complacent. I mean, perfectionism is how we take it, right? So it's all about, you know, your perspective towards perfectionism. So, you know, if we just do not pursue perfectionism at all, state of complacency, you know, would set in, is what I guess, you know, you're focusing on. And so it needs to be relative, it needs to be understood in different perspective. Yes. So I think the results are almost ready. So we'll be just back in a while.
Mm-hmm.
While the results are being compiled, may I please request our judge, Ms. Shobha Srivastava, to please give her views on the event.
Thanks, Shreya. It's been a wonderful, journey going through this debate competition. And trust me, the kind of thoughts that have come up, of course, all the participants did a lot of research work in what went into the content. But clearly, the perspectives that were coming on, it's so easy for us to be at one end, the dismissive of perfectionism, to say that, why put pressure on people and let them be what they are. But the participants were so amazingly able to put across how the pursuit of, perfectionism is as important and not just let things be. So, the one thing that's takeaway, and I think most participants would have felt it so too, that while the topic was about, is the pressure of perfectionism one of the leading causes of mental health issues, what I heard repeatedly was that we need to pursue perfectionism. Not for a moment are we, either as faculty or as parents, or any stakeholders, or even as students, in denial of the fact that we need to do our things well, we need to push our envelope, we need to push our limits. Only then will we know what we are capable of. But having said that, it's also important to not let that pressure become negative pressure. As some of the participants very rightly said, we are talking about good pressure. We are talking about positive pressure, a pressure which exerts on to do better. The moment that pressure starts turning us into anxious beings, then that pressure is no more positive. The moment our mental health starts crumbling, we are facing panic attacks or anxiety attacks, that's a time we need to sit up and see that whatever pressure I was putting myself to in terms of, getting better marks, looking better, feeling better, whatever are the goalposts, the moment that happens, clearly it's not a positive pressure. It is putting my mental well-being and out of it, my total well-being on a downward slide. And that is something for all of us to look at, all these stakeholders. The good thing would be that while all the participants who spoke on this topic for this debate looked into the content, my request, my submission to all the children who are logged in today, to the faculty, to the management, would be that it's not just a debate. We don't lose sight of what we have spoken and heard today. Even as, you know, the semester exams begin for the boards, and we are now grappling with a two-semester system. Some of us are happy, some of us are not. And the way forward, it is important for us to know that our pressure has to be positive. It has to help us do better, feel better. The moment that feel better leads us, it's a wake-up call. That is really what, you know, each one of you, all the teams that are here, that's a message that you need to carry back to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, to everybody around you, that let the pressure be positive. The moment it's anxiety, the moment it's not a pursuit, it's something that I am unwillingly taking on my shoulders and I'm not feeling good about it. We really have to sit back and look through what we are doing and how we are also putting our goalposts together. Some of the goalposts are about, I really liked, you know, what one of the participants, Yashaswini, said about, you know, when we put an egg and a potato in boiling water, the egg hardens up while the potato softens up, right? So it's not about the water. The water is the same for everybody. It's really how the potato takes it and the egg takes it. And I thought that was a very beautiful symbolism that was shared. And that is what we need to always remember on. So that is all that I would want to share at this juncture. We are all waiting for the results. Even I don't know what the result is going to be because we have all, you know, looked at it differently. So the panelists have had their own thoughts on that. But it's been a beautiful experience. And I would like to just thank the Vishwa Bharati Public School management, the teachers, the coordinator, Shreya, and each one of you who has come together to put this, memorabilia in, you know, honor of late Sri Ganju together. This is a wonderful event. And the fact that we are in COVID times, we have been able to get out of it, to make the most out of the virtual medium, not letting anything stop us. I think that's the spirit of human perfectionism that sits and resides in all of us in whatever measure it be. The very fact that we work against odds is also a journey or a pursuit of, you know, perfectionism. And that's what we see day in, day out, each one of us, every one of us. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Shubha ma'am. And yes, you're right that this is a virtual platform. And, you know, we did not want to, put on the result for another date. And that's why we decided to take a little time now, but share the result. I think it's almost done. So please bear with us for another 1 or 2 minutes and we'll be there with the result. Thank you.
Meanwhile, I would also like to thank the team, the management, and all the principals, teachers, and everyone, of course, the students who made such a great effort in preparing for this debate, in researching, in, you know, all the everything, the voice modulation, the expression, the gestures which we saw, the content. It is not only about the content, it is how you present it and what are your gestures, how are your expressions, how you are modulating your voice. So it was an enlightening experience for us as well. And it's always so good to see students, you know, coming up to this level and, you know, interacting and, you know, putting their views forth. So about perfectionism, it just came to my mind, you know, nature is never perfect. There's a law of entropy, if anyone has heard about it. It's like, you know, everything in order moves towards a state of disorder. Nature is never perfect, and that is why it is so beautiful, right? So in nature, and everything grows and creates. When we are moving towards creation, we don't think about perfection. We only think about creation. And that's the main aim of human life. How do you fulfill ourselves? Through creation. We have to keep creating new things all the time. Whether it's, you know, an artwork, whether it's planting trees, growing gardens, whether it is music or art, or whether it is, you know, developing a software, anything which leads to creation is what you're supposed to be, what you're supposed to do. That's the main goal of human life. Okay. And whatever it takes to do that, you have to be, you want to do it in an organized, perfect way, you do that. But even if there are imperfections in your perfections, that's fine. That's okay. Right? Because as I said, nature is never perfect. If you see a garden or a meadow, you see brown leaves and yellow leaves also. You see the falling leaves and you see a lot of, you know, worms and insects all over the garden. I mean, just imagine a garden which has no falling leaves, no yellow leaves, no brown leaves. How would it look? It will look very unnatural, right? So nature is always imperfect, and we have to, you know, follow nature, and we can, you know, we must learn from our mistakes and lead a life of fulfillment. That is what I want to say. Thank you.
Thank you. So finally, the much awaited results. I would just like to add one thing. Since VVPS Noida is the host school, so we are not in the race for the competition. And now let me announce the best speaker for the motion. Raza Sharma from DPS Greater Noida.
I think, ma'am, we can request,
put on. I would request all of you to please switch on your videos. Prabha Gupta, ma'am. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. So we have DPS Greater Noida, Raza Sharma. She is first for the motion. And Vishwabharati Public School, Dwarka. Khushi Rawat. She's second. She's again first for the against the motion. Congratulations. Now, second best. This is individual awards I'm announcing. Ishmit from Somerville, Noida is second best for the motion. And Manasvi Rawat from Vishwabharati, Dwarka is second, again, for the motion. There's a tie. And Anukriti Chaturvedi from DPS Greater Noida is second against the motion. Now, the much awaited. Let me announce the runners-up team. Well, it's all in the family. This is Vishwabharati Public School, Dwarka. Is runners up, overall winners, runners up. And the overall trophy, the Sri S.N. Ganju Memorial Interschool Trophy for the best team goes to DPS Greater Noida. And this is the team, and this is the trophy which we'll be sending across to the school principal. This is the one. Congratulations to one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. Over to you.
And many, many congratulations. As you can see that we, ma'am is just showing the rolling trophy.
Yeah, I'm really happy.
Yes, absolutely. And there's a picture of the rolling trophy, which is displayed on the screen as well. And this is what, you know, the Delhi Public School, Greater Noida has backed. Many congratulations to the team members, Reza and Anuprati Chaturvedi, and to the teacher in charge. And we will be sending across this trophy over to the school. You will be responsible for retaining it for a period of 1 year. And and will hold this responsibility of its maintenance as well, right? Thank you so much, and many congratulations, you know, to the winners, right? So now we've almost come to the end of the event, and it's my privilege to propose the vote of thanks to each and everyone present here this morning on the occasion of Shri S. N. Ganju Memorial Inter-School English Debate for 2021. At the very outset, on behalf of Team Vishwabharati, we would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to our honorable management members for joining us this morning and boosting the morale of all of us. We sincerely thank our elite panel of judges, Ms. Pratika Mishra and Ms. Shubha Srivastava, for taking out time for judging today's event. We would also like to thank the principals of our sister concerns and teacher in charges of participating schools for joining us today. Today's debating event is a testimony to the fact that these young leaders are redefining excellence in every which way, right from expressing their opinions convincingly to opposing their opponent's viewpoint logically. All the participants have done it all so confidently. We thank each one of you for your enthusiastic participation and look forward to the same in coming times as well. Many congratulations to all the winners. And last but not the least, a special gratitude to all the students and the teachers and everyone who's involved in making this event a grand success. Thank you all.
Just request them to switch on the camera so that we have a group photograph. We'll be doing it.
We'll be asking them to switch on their camera after the school song, ma'am. Yeah. All right. Thank you all very much once again. And over to you, Shreya.
Thank you, ma'am. It is better to participate and fail than fail to participate. I thank everyone for making this event a great success, and we hope to see the same enthusiasm in the coming years. I now request everyone to please join us for the school song.
Thank you.
Very good.
We now come to the end of the event. Thank you everyone for being with us. May I please request everyone to turn on their videos so that we can capture this moment.
Yes. Tina, you're not visible. Who's clicking the photographs? Kaun click kar raha hai?
Mom, it is all getting recorded.
Oh, that's great, Meenakshi. Thank you. Thank you, Meenakshi, ma'am. I just saw you.
Thank you, ma'am, so much.
Oh, ma'am, thank you so you're much for being here.
Thank you so much.
Veena, ma'am, we could not hear the result.
No problem. We'll be sending you across today itself through mail. I'll just send you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone, for joining. And may I also request my colleagues, all those who are involved in today's event, to put on their video as well.
Yeah, I cannot.
Yes, Archana, Parul, and Tina.
And I can see Archana Tina is there. Good, good. Thank Anna, you. Ma'am. Ansh is there. Yes, thank you, Ansh.
Yes, Ansh is
Sparsh,
there.
I can't see Sparsh.
Yes, Sparsh Goyal is there, ma'am. I can see him. Yes, yes, yes. So may I even request our guests to kindly put on their videos?
Akshita, you also switch on your video?
Yes, Akshita.
Ganjo sir has to see this side.
Yes, sir. Sir, please face the camera, sir.
Ganjo sir, please face the camera. I'll just give him.
Yes, sir.
So please face the camera. We are clicking the photographs. You have to face the camera. Perfect.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Perfect. Thank you, sir. Thanks.
Thank you, everyone, for making this event so special.
Next year.
Okay. Yes.
Thank you.